मेजर इम्पीडेंस वोल्टेज एंड लोड लॉसेस ऑफ थ्री फेज ट्रांसफॉर्मर. मेक द कनेक्शंस एज पर दिस सर्किट डायग्राम. हियर आई एम कंसिडरिंग टू एलिमेंट वेट मीटर एंड ट्रांसफॉर्मर अंडर टेस्ट इज ऑफ 3 KVA विच इज डेल्टा स्टार. सो प्राइमरी इज इन डेल्टा एंड सेकेंडरी इज इन स्टार कनेक्टेड. प्राइमरी वोल्टेज इज 230 वोल्ट वेर एज सेकेंडरी वोल्टेज इज 115 वोल्ट. दिस पर्टिकुलर सेट इज फॉर मेजरिंग इम्पीडेंस वोल्टेज एंड लोड लॉसेज ऑफ थ्री फेज ट्रांसफॉर्मर. सो और एम इज टू मेजर इम्पीडेंस वोल्टेज एंड लोड लॉसेज ऑफ थ्री फेज ट्रांसफॉर्मर. दिस इज अ ट्रांसफॉर्मर अंडर टेस्ट. इट इज 3 KVA ट्रांसफॉर्मर एंड इट इज स्पेशली डिजाइंड फॉर प्रैक्टिकल पर्पज. सो इट्स प्राइमरी इज डिजाइंड फॉर 230 वोल्ट एंड सेकेंडरी इज 115 वोल्ट. प्राइमरी इज कनेक्टेड इन डेल्टा एंड सेकेंडरी इज इन स्टार कनेक्शन. एज इट इज अ शॉर्ट सर्किट टेस्ट सेकेंडरी टर्मिनल्स आर शॉर्ट सर्किटेड. It is 3 KVA transformer. So just look at this calculations. It is 3 KVA transformer, three phase transformer is this is. So to conduct this experiment, we need to circulate rated current or current below rated value during short circuit. So as per the given rating, rated primary current is calculated for 3 KVA. Primary voltage is 230 volt. So after calculation, we get rated primary current as 7.53 ampere. And this is the observation table. After performing this test, you have to note down applied voltage, VSC, short circuit current, ISC, and short circuit power, WSC. As shown here, for this particular transformer test, connections are made here. From supply terminals, it is as I told, it is specially designed for practical purpose. So though it is three phase supply, it is designed for 230 volt. Okay, so 230 volt three phase supply RYB is provided to auto transformer, and from auto transformer supply is connected to three phase transformer. For the measurement of VSC, ISC and WSC, we are having voltmeter, ammeter and wattmeter in the circuit, and from line terminals of this particular two element wattmeter, connections are provided to load or transformer. So it is your transformer under test. So supply is provided to primary side of this particular transformer, and these are the input supply terminals of this particular transformer. Now to conduct this transformer, I am going to switch on the supply from 230 volt, and to circulate the rated current. Now we have calculated rated current of this particular transformer as 7.53, so we can circulate up to 7.53, but this particular experiment is possible to conduct below rated value. So here I am going to set 3.5 ampere. So to circulate 3.5 ampere, I am going to apply some voltage by varying the stud of this particular auto transformer, and just by measuring the voltage with this voltmeter, we will note down the voltage required to circulate 3.5 ampere. That will be the VSC current which is going to circulate through this particular primary winding is 3.5, which I am going to set here. And at that time, the wattmeter reading, whatever is shown on this dial, is noted down, which is nothing but WSC. After making switch on, 230 volt supply is provided to auto transformer as an input, and from auto transformer I am going to circulate 3.6 ampere current through this primary winding. So during this short circuit condition, I am circulating 3.6 ampere current, and for that voltage required VSC is 15.7. so it is 15.7 volt. At that condition, power required to circulate this much current is very small one. It is around 25 watt. So note down the reading. ISC 3.6, WSC 25, and VSC 15.7.
Calculations. Now from reading, we have already entered all data in observation table. So now we are in position to calculate load losses, short circuit impedance per phase, resistance per phase. Definitely it is referred to primary side only, primary R01 per phase we are going to calculate. Similarly, reactance per phase, that is of primary winding, we are going to calculate.
We are having all readings entered in our observation table. So from this reading, we are able to find out different parameters. Total power loss in three-phase transformer is 25 watt. So per phase power loss is equal to 25 by 3, that is 8.33 watt. In this particular practical, in this transformer, we are considering primary winding in delta. So per phase current, we need to calculate first to calculate impedance per phase. So for the calculation of ZSC, we are considering VSC upon ISC by root 3. So putting the value, we are getting value of ZSC is equal to 7.54 ohm. Next step is finding value of resistor per phase, refer to primary. So to calculate R01, rearranging the terms, we are getting 8.33 divided by 3.6 by root 3, it is 4 ohm. So resistor per phase is 4 ohm. Generally, the value of resistor is kept minimum because R01 is responsible for power loss in the transformer. So to reduce the power loss, the value of R01 should be minimum 1. And the last parameter which we need to calculate here is reactance per phase. So X01 is equal to under root ZSC square minus R01 square. So putting the value of ZSC and R01 in this formula, we are getting primary winding reactance per phase is equal to 6.39 ohm. If we are going to compare the value of this X01 in case of power transformer and in case of distribution transformer, then we may find that value of X01 is greater in case of power transformer than that of distribution transformer. The reason behind it is, in case of distribution transformer, we are in a, our main interest is to avoid voltage drop. So it should be minimum 1 for distribution. And for transmission side, or in case of power transformer, if any fault occurs, there is any short circuit, so the reactance of that particular transformer, self-reactance of that transformer comes into picture, and it works as a protection, gives protection. So for that purpose, to control the current or to limit the current, it is purposefully kept higher one in case of power transformer. Okay. So this is how we are able to find out power loss and impedance per phase, as well as R01 and X01 in case of three-phase transformer.